In this course, I'm going to be showing you how you can connect your PHP code to a MySQL database. And MySQL is an open source relational database management system. So that's RDBMS. And it's actually one of the most popular ones, second most popular RDBMS within the world. And it's open source. And I'm going to show you how we can connect to it and begin working with it. So in this course, I'm going to be using Brackets as my editor. If you already have a favorite editor, or if you've got one that you're really comfortable with, then you don't really need to switch over to Brackets in order to be able to do the same things that I'm going to be doing within the course. But if you're looking for a new editor, Brackets is a really cool one. It's from Adobe, and if you want to download it, it's from Brackets.io. You can just go over to their website to download it. Some of the other resources that I'm using within this course as well. So I'm going to be using a XAMPP server. So what this does is this gives me the ability to run a local machine on my computer. So essentially that gives me the ability to run a simulated server on my system, so I don't actually need to have web hosting with a database in order to practice connecting to a database. And if you're familiar with PHP code, then you know that you do need a server in order to run PHP. And this gives you everything you need right out of the box. So this is my control panel for XAMPP. And you see here, I've got my Apache server, so I can start that up. I've got a MySQL database, I can start that up. And I've got a few other options here, but I'm not going to be using these within this course. So if you are looking for a way to practice this, this is a really great resource. And as you can see here, there's a Windows version, a Linux version, and an OS X version. And now they also even have support for PHP 7. So if you're a big fan of PHP and you want to check out what's new with PHP 7, this is also a resource that you can really easily set up and get going with. So besides that, we're also going to be looking at several websites. So of course, because we're basing the course around MySQL, there's a core website for MySQL, and that's the mysql.com. So a lot of good information here, of course. You can got some documentation here and just developer zone. So a lot of really cool resources for MySQL. We're also going to be using Heidi SQL as well. So I'm going to show you how to connect to your database using an application. And again, I'm on a Windows machine, so this is why I'm going to be using Heidi, but there's quite a lot of other ones that you can use as well. And I'm going to be running through some of those alternatives as well within this course. And then lastly, so I'm going to set up my XAMPP server. I'm going to go over to localhost and I'm going to run my code there within my Chrome browser. And we're probably not going to be doing too much with the browser. And of course, because the code is going to be running on the back end, it's not going to be as relevant to what type of browser you're going to be using. So you could use any browser that you're comfortable with using. And I usually use Chrome because I really like a lot of the features that are available in Chrome, and it really helps with web development and communication. So once you've gone over to XAMPP, and of course, if you already have a system set up, like if you're running a VirtualBox and you already have a local machine set up with a database, then you don't have to go ahead and download XAMPP. This was just for illustration purposes, and we are going to be using PHP MyAdmin, so that comes as well within XAMPP, and that's going to give us the ability to access some of our database content. So either way, if you have this, if you're looking for something to install, this is the place to start. So once you go ahead and just download it, and you can just really literally click through those setup files, and at the end it's going to ask you to launch it. So this is my already installed version, and it's all ready to go. There's one thing that I do usually do within the courses, because with XAMPP, we always try to use this default directory. So there's that C drive directory that it by default goes to. So you can change that in the configuration if you're storing your web files somewhere else. And you, of course, you can change the SQL as well, but usually I just use the default location for that. So I'll quickly show you how to change that as well if you do choose to use XAMPP. So in order to change your configuration, so you just go over to here and there's a file called httpd.config. So just go ahead and click that, and that's going to open up that file. And then within this file, so I've got a defaulting going over to brackets. So again, if you've got the default, depending on what the defaults are set, it may or may not be different. So you scroll down all the way down to roughly around line, it's probably going to be around line 244, 245. So I do have some updates here that I've done on my system, and I want to make sure that it's actually booting over to my file here where I'm going to start this MySQL content. So I'm just going to have to change the folder area, because right now if I started it up, it would try to go over to this Angular folder, and this is not where I want to create the course files. So I've got it on my computer at k/websites/mysql. So once I've set that, I can just simply save that, and now I can go over here and start it up. And so I don't have anything stored here yet, so I'm going to just create an index file and save this as index.html within that MySQL directory that I've created. And of course, we're going to call it index.html. And now when we go back out to our localhost and refresh it, we've got hello world. So that just means that we're all set up, ready to go. And of course, we've got PHP now running, and we've got the database, so we can go to PHP MyAdmin. So just type in localhost/phpMyAdmin, and I do have the screen pretty big here, so I'm just going to shrink it back down to 100%, and we're all ready to go with starting to work and create our content for the course. So in the next lesson, we're going to get started. We're going to show you how to make a connection to the database and start interacting with some of this data content using PHP and MySQL.